Hello students, this is Shweta Roy. This video is for class 18, SST, chapter 1, part 2, political science, our constitution. In this video, I am going to explain the topic, features of Indian constitution. So, our constitution starts with the preamble. Preamble means an introduction in which purpose of the constitution is given. That means why this constitution is made, that purpose, that ideals and principles of constitution is given in the preamble. It is an introduction of the constitution. Now we will go to the salient features of our constitution. So our constitution is a detailed written constitution. It is the name-based constitution of the world. It is divided into 22 parts, 395 articles, 8 schedules, and 4 more schedules were added later. Now, it elaborates the governmental structure at center, state, local level. That means what are their duties, what are the functions, that is all mentioned in the constitution. Not only this, what is the duties of people, what are the rights of people, what is citizenship, what is election, about the principles of state, directed principles of state, state policies, oh, everything is mentioned in the constitution. That means everything mentioned clearly in the constitution, and that is detailed. Now, our constitution also has provision of amendment. It is a living document. Why it is called living document? Because it changes according to the time, according to the need of the people. And that is why it is called living document. Actually, in constitution itself, there is a provision. That means changes can be done in the constitution. And that changes are called amendment. Now, it is our country is a sovereign, democratic and republican. How it is? Sovereign means it is free from external power. That means India can make their own policies. They can implement their own policies. No foreign country can force them to do anything. They cannot force them to follow anything. So they are free from the external power. No one can force them to do anything. It is also a democratic country. How it is democratic? Because it has given right to the people of the country. That means the people of the country can elect their representatives and who can run the government. This is called universal franchise, universal adult franchise. According to universal adult franchise, a person who is 18 or above of age, they can vote, they can elect their representative. Elect their leader, and those leader will run the country. They will govern the country. So that right is given to the people of India, and that is why this country is democratic. Now we have republic. Our country is also republic because head of the nation, that is president, he is elected by the people's representative. That means representative who are elected. caste, sex, color, education, or wealth. So this kind of discrimination is prevented, and all the people in the country, whether of any color, whether of any caste, whether of any sex, whether of any economic condition, economic status, they are equal in front of the constitution. Now, it is secular country. That means, A, the government of India does not officially promote any religion. It cannot make any kind of rule which give importance to any religion and which can create discrimination among the people on the basis of religion. That means people being of any religion, irrespective of any religion, they are equal among the equal among the constitution. So that equality is given on the terms of social, economic, or religion equality has been given to the people of India. Now our country is also federalism. That means it votes on more than one level. Actually, India is a vast country, and to control that country, govern that country on one center is difficult. So we have our government on two levels, that is central and state level. Now we also have local level, which votes on the local level. Now our constitution democrates the power of the central and state in these lists. These are union list, state list, and concurrent list. Now that means the responsibilities, whatever duties are there, that is divided in these three lists. Now whatever subjects are given under the union list, that will be taken here by the center. Whatever subjects are given in state list, that will be taken here by the state. Whatever subject is given under concurrent list, that will be together taken care by the center and state. That means on that subject, center and state has to work together. Now here, we also have separation of power. In this, we have three organs in our government. Here we have legislature, then we have the executive, and then we have the judiciary. Now the work of legislature is to make laws. Here we have in legislature, we have elected representatives. The representatives whom we elect, they will be here in the legislature and they will make the laws. Now executive is here. So executive will implement the laws. Their work is to implement the laws which are made in the legislature. Now we have judiciary. In judiciary, they interpret the laws. That means the laws are followed properly or not. This will be taken care by the judiciary system. Judiciary system is actually the system of court. Here you can see the power is separated here. The legislature will make the laws, the executive will implement the laws, and judiciary The elected representatives are born there and they represent the people of the country. According to the constitution, the people of country has right to elect their government, elect their representatives who will run the government by universal adult franchise. Thank you.